In this illustration, we'll demonstrate you the internal reflection at the interface of a prism and a slab. Here we are given that a right angle prism of refractive index mu 1 is attached with a transparent plate of refractive index mu 2, as we can see in the figure, at the diagonal face of prism, and we are required to calculate the angle of incidence of a light ray on face AB, for which the light will be internally reflected on the face AC. Here in solution, we can see by Snell's law, here we can write when light is incident on this face. Here I can draw the picture again and we can see it carefully. This mu 1, this mu 2, this angle is 45 degree. So if light is incident at an angle I, this will refract and finally incident on the other face at theta C. So the angle at which the light ray is refracting in the glass slab must be 45 degree minus theta C, as the sum of these two refracting angles must be equal to the prism angle. So in this situation, by Snell's law, we can write here sin I is equals to mu 1 sin of theta, where the angle of refraction here can be written as 45 minus theta C. So this is our equation 1. And for phase AC, if we just have a look, we can write for phase AC. Here we are using Snell's law at phase AB. Now at phase AC, we can write it as mu 1 sin theta C is equals to mu 2. That is our equation 2. If we further simplify these relations, then from equation 1, we can get, if you open it, the sin I is equals to mu 1, the sin 45 cos theta C minus cos 45 sin theta C. So this mu 1 by root 2 cos theta C minus sin theta C. And in this situation, we can further write it mu 1 by root 2, and cos theta C we can write root of 1 minus sin square theta C minus sin theta C. And the value of sin theta C we can substitute from here, that is mu 2 by mu 1. So here the value of sin I we are getting is mu 1 by root 2 multiplied by root of 1 minus mu 2 square by mu 1 square minus mu 2 by mu 1. So further on simplifying, this mu 1 gets cancelled out and the value of I we are getting is sin inverse of is 1 by root 2 times root of mu 1 square minus mu 2 square minus mu 2. This is our final result of the problem.